training and synthesis. And we actually have three main deliverables. There are two reports. The first one is a report based on the findings from the case studies integration and synthesis, and also their potential for upscaling. The other one is, after the upscaling has been done, to look at the potential for applying the methods across Europe. And then the last one is a communication tool to show the application of those measures across Europe in an interactive way. Different tasks. So as I said, first to synthesize and integrate results from the different study sites. Then to upscale them using modeling. Next, to think about if we use modeling and model into the future, what are the different future uncertainties we have to take into account, and dealing with that in conjunction with the modeling. And then finally, for communication purposes, the mapping tool. First task, the summary and integration of the results. And we start with Work Package 2. So we would also like to be involved in that work package to already start from the beginning and thinking about the integration and the upscaling. Because for us it's very difficult to, once the experiments are finished, only then to do the upscaling. Also because I think that's probably around month 50, so that will be too late to start. And also for us it's very important for all of you involved in the study sites to start thinking from the start where you see potential for upscaling, applying techniques across Europe, etc. And so the second part of this is then the assessment itself, to see where different techniques are transferable in other regions in Europe and what circumstances can be biophysical but also socioeconomic, and then use that in the modeling in the next step. The second one is to develop an integrated assessment model, and this model is going to be spatially explicit. In the DAO we wrote it would be at local level probably around 100-500 meter resolution, a grid, but we're definitely aiming for 100 meter resolution because we like to work with a hectare scale at farm level to work with those plots. So the idea here is that we make this integrated assessment model that builds on previous European-wide approaches, and it focuses on macro and microeconomics, biophysical processes, land use change, and farmer behavior. The model will have different spatial scales depending on different interests for different users, and also where different processes play a role. And then, as I said, spatial resolution at local level, we try to keep it to 100 meter. Time horizon, we put in 2050, but we can discuss that, and at the moment we're quite flexible. Temporal resolution, most likely a combination of months and years depending on the different components that are in there. But also this can be discussed with everybody who is involved. Just an example, we started the EU-wide modeling about 15 years ago with a project called LUMACAP, Land Use Modeling from the Common Agricultural Policy. And also this model already has four different spatial scales: EU-wide, national, regional and local. And as you see, there are big feedbacks between local, regional, national, which we would like in this project as well. Back then, local scale is still a kilometer, but nowadays we do think there is better data and also software capabilities to run applications throughout Europe at a more detailed resolution. Just an idea of what was in LUMACAP, so it is definitely not the system diagram for this project, but as you can see, also here you have the different spatial scales. And then there are different components like agriculture, economics, socioeconomics, climate, and then more detailed at local level, land use, crop choice, physical suitability, and also indicators at the various levels. And we normally also like to wrap it up in a software package that you can easily link external drivers, policy options, and indicators, and have visual interpretations of results. So as I said, it builds on work done in previous projects, and the main work we're aiming to do here is to enhance the biophysical model. The biophysical model includes the PCERA model, and to enhance it, you know, is mainly to improve, to put a the management options in there. And we hope to collaborate with Work Package 2 for the general understanding, and then Work Package 5 for the information from the different study sites. Then also, for us it's not just modeling, but really to think about policy impact assessment. So that means a link to relevant policies, but also relevant indicators in terms of ecosystem services, profitability, sustainability. And the policy link is mainly with Milieu, Work Package 7. And then also the indicators we would like to tune with Work Package 4 to make sure that we try to assess similar things at EU level as is done in study sites. Sometimes, of course, we'll have to calculate them differently, but that's, I think, also part of the research to see what kind of upscaling we should use in doing so. Then, in the previous projects, we used to have a lot of macroeconomic modeling and some microeconomic modeling, but the feedback between them wasn't very strong. So we would like to improve both the macro and the microeconomic modeling, but also very much focus on those feedback mechanisms between local and more global scale economics. And that work will mainly be done also in collaboration with Luc Fleskens from Wageningen University and also with Leuven. And then finally, at local level, we work with an agent-based model for farmer decisions, and that includes the microeconomics but also biophysical aspects. And in here, we are keen on working together with Work Package 3. Because also, of course, when you think about farmer behavior, adoption plays an important role. So there we hope to see what can be upskilled and used throughout Europe. As I mentioned, we're also looking into different aspects of future uncertainty. And for this, we don't necessarily just use modeling, because we found that when we make integrated models for policy support, it's often very difficult for policymakers to understand what is going on and really to make the link from modeling to policymaking. For this reason, we like to work with more qualitative scenarios, and also we are here developing exploratory scenarios, so thinking about very different worldviews and how the future might unfold in those different worldviews. And this is a technique that we normally use as a combination of workshops or participation, analysis, and also the integrated assessment model developed in the previous task. So it includes qualitative and quantitative aspects. Qualitative are the narratives, the stories about the future. They can be very creative, very rich, and much richer than the pure modeling. And the modeling brings scientific input into those scenarios, and also looks at the, is better in finding the consistency of the whole reasoning and the coherence. And moreover, it adds to the visual interpretation in making things explicit, spatially. And then once we have those scenarios, which would be probably around 3 to 5 pathways for the future, we aim to test the different policies and combination of policies under those scenarios to have a more robust assessment of policy impact. And as I said, so this part is much more participatory than the first task, or the second task. And then finally, task 6.4 is to develop an interactive mapping tool, which is really used as a communication tool, and on the web, so people can look where in Europe which systems or management techniques can be applied. And then we hope to provide not just the biophysical basis for this, but also the socio-economic implications, the adoption, look what kind of machinery is required, etc. And also in doing so, we hope to give them an image of what would work, how things would work out under those different scenarios developed in task 3. So it's based on the work from 6.2 and 6.3. And here I would like to discuss with JRC also how much work is going to be led by them, how much by us, and where we, where to collaborate. So for this afternoon, I would like to have a first question discussion about what our work package is, so please ask whatever you would like to ask, and also if you have ideas to contribute, please let me know. Then mainly focus on the upscaling, and to hear what you think about applying, and on different management techniques, whether it would work in Europe or not. Then for Wednesday, we thought to have an hour, which we aim to have in a little bit bigger group, more presentations, so it's rep package 6 and 7. So presentation about integrated assessment modeling, but also policy impact assessment. And then probably in a little bit smaller group, discuss some of the, I would say, key collaborative issues in our rep packages. So one is the link between policy impact assessment in rep package 7 and integrated assessment modeling in rep package 6. The other one is those exploratory scenarios. What should be their role and how should we develop it? And there will be, the work package 3, 6, 7, and also others that are interested in collaborating there. Adoption, so that will be mainly work package 3 and 6. And interaction, micro and macroeconomics. Thank you. This is for our work package.